Hello students, welcome you all in my YouTube channel. This is Shaista, your geography teacher, and I'm here back with you all with the class 7 geography. And today I will discuss chapter number 4, the air. Students, I have already made 3 more video lectures regarding the chapter air, okay? And we were discussing about the elements of weather and climate, okay? The elements of weather of climate are temperature, pressure, wind and rainfall. This we have already seen in my previous video lecture, and I have already discuss about the temperature, how temperature affect the weather and climate of a place. Now in today's video lecture, I will discuss about the air pressure, how air pressure affects the weather and climate of a place. So here we go. Air pressure. Air pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by the weight of air on the earth's surface. It is expressed in units of millibars and is measured with a barometer. You know students, as we go up the layers of atmosphere, the pressure falls rapidly. The air pressure is highest at sea level and decreases with height. Horizontally, the distribution of air pressure is influenced by temperature of air at a given place. In areas where temperature is high, the air gets heated and rises. This creates a low pressure area. And the low pressure area is associated with cloudy sky and weather is wet, that is wet weather. Now in areas which are having lower temperature, the air is cool over there. It is therefore, it is heavy, okay, the air is heavy. Heavy air sinks and creates a high pressure area. A high pressure is associated with clear and sunny skies, okay? What contrast we have seen, that low pressure is associated with cloudy skies and wet weather, and whereas the high pressure is associated with clear and sunny skies, okay? And the air always moves from the high pressure areas to low pressure areas, okay? In this manner, the air circulation took place. Now we will discuss the factors affecting air pressure. So what are these factors? The factors which affect the air pressure are altitude, temperature, moisture, and slope of the land. Altitude. Air pressure decreases with an increase in temperature. As we go higher into the atmosphere, there is a decrease in the density of air, and so air pressure decreases. Temperature. With an increase in temperature, air expands, becomes lighter and rises upwards, producing low pressure and thus exerts less pressure on the surface of the earth. Similarly, when the surface temperature is extremely, you know, cold, the air above is cooled and, you know, hot, and consequently contracts, become heavier and denser, causing higher pressure. Moisture. Air containing water vapor is lighter than dry air. Hence, an increase in the moisture content in the atmosphere leads to a decrease in the pressure. In this way, the moisture affects the air pressure of any particular region. Now, rotation of the earth. The rotation of the earth at times displaces the mass of air, causing a change in the pressure condition of the area. Now, we will discuss about the pressure belt. Students, you know, there are various pressure belts which are found on the surface of the earth, or which acts on the surface of the earth. They are equatorial low pressure belt, tropical high pressure belt, subpolar low pressure belt, polar high pressure belt. Now we will see them one by one. Equatorial low pressure belt or doldrums. The equatorial region is a zone of low pressure. Due to high temperature throughout the year, it is called the equatorial low pressure belt, or it is also known as doldrums. Tropical high pressure belt. It's subtropical high pressure belt. The air that rises upwards from the equatorial region descends after being cooled in the subtropical region around 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south. This creates the subtropical high pressure belt. This belt is also referred to as horse latitude. Okay. Now, subpolar low pressure belt. Due to Earth's rotation, the air swings towards the equator and thins out over the areas around 60 degrees north and 60 degrees south. This creates the subpolar low pressure belt. And the last, polar high pressure belt. In the polar areas, the low temperature results in cold, heavy air that creates high pressure. These areas around the North Pole and South Pole are the polar high pressure belt. So, my dear students, and we will discuss this much in this video lecture, and in my next video lecture, I am going to discuss about the wind, how wind affects the weather and climate of any particular region. Till then, you all go through my video lecture. Okay, like and subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a nice day.